If you reach, niggas bleed. I am what they need. I am so
wash your hands.
Absolutely.
Because motherfuckers need to wash their hands.
Right.
Bro, that's the
right.
Hey, that's when 99% of diseases start. Like, niggas not washing their hands and touching everybody and everything.
Right.
My nigga, if you go out there, I be going out to eat, bro. Niggas, white people, they be taking pisses and shit, taking shits and just walking clean the fuck out, bro.
Yeah,
bro. That's crazy.
Gripping
that
the handles with the force, you know what I'm saying?
Their
whole... Everything is on that door handle
Why
now.
Why do y'all think they don't wash their hands?
I don't know,
bro. They in a hurry,
bro. Because, tell me, as us as kids, right?
Yeah.
Yo, you, like, I'm just saying, you go use the bathroom, wash your hands. Wash your hands.
You wash your hands as soon as you
come
out.
So it's like, it's just...
You know what?
It could,
you know, like you just said, be a cultural thing, because if you think about the like slavery based movies that you've seen, you know, they had those outhouses. A lot of people, you know, that are white, they grew up on those farms. They use those things. Maybe it's just like, oh, this is where we know you just get up. There's no bathroom with a sink and running water. You know what I'm saying? Maybe we were all just raised like that and just continue to live our lives like that. That's the only way that shit makes sense in my mind.
Fact.
And that shit sounds stupid. You know what I'm saying?
And it is. It's stupid for them to not motherfucking wash their hands.
Like,
so,
wash your hands.
Right. Wash your goddamn hands, man.
What's soap?
A thing that I didn't know about the coronavirus is that this shit was already out. And this is just a new version of it.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Oh, I saw somebody said The Simpsons had posted about that shit in like 96 or
Absolutely.
Something.
Absolutely. It was a whole episode of The Simpsons. And that's when I seen the cartoon.
The Simpsons be telling you the future, bro. This shit crazy.
Yeah,
they do.
That's crazy.
They definitely
They've
do.
Been right a few times, yeah.
A couple times. That shit crazy, bro.
Yeah, because I seen the Kobe cartoon, too, with the shit. You know what I'm saying? I seen,
I heard about that.
On
Kobe
the Simpsons.
What you mean?
I think I seen the Kobe cartoon on The Simpsons, or it was on YouTube. I seen The Simpsons coronavirus, the Kobe helicopter shit. No cut. I seen the shit on YouTube.
That's crazy. Yeah.
Yes, I seen the shit. Like, with my own eyes. I don't know if it was The Simpsons, though. I might be boosting. It was a cartoon, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I heard about it. Yeah,
and I seen that shit at my homeboy
crib.
Ago. Yes,
yeah.
It was done a long time ago.
Yeah.
And
predicting,
you know,
that he would die in like a helicopter crash type shit.
Yeah,
it's fucking crazy.
It is. And well, RIP Kobe.
Yeah, rest
they just had the, what was it called?
Memorial.
The memorial service.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, everybody's in a uproar because because his family didn't speak or some shit, right?
Yeah.
Which
gives a fuck, bro.
Who gives a fuck?
I'm saying, like, they don't want to speak. They ain't got to speak, bro.
Absolutely. Yeah. Right, right.
They might not want to express how they can't. Maybe they can't express how they feel. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Let them live, bro.
Yeah, I can't imagine what they're going through. God bless their family.
Facts. Man. God bless the family.
God bless them.
All that, man. You know, we want to send our condolences to their family.
Yeah.
But here we are and on the scam cast. So
Sweet.
Death is something that happens, you know.
Yeah.
I remember, you know, the homie died, man. He can get some light shined on him. Quan,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I believe that was kind of motivation for yourself, because I remember you putting sentimental posts out and shit.
Now,
you know, you going to use that bad energy, but use it towards something else. So talk about that, like how, you know, you're doing the right thing, and just talk about the motivation, because congrats on fatherhood. You got how many kids now?
I got three kids. I got two biological children, one stepchild, but I love them all the same, you know?
Absolutely.
Dad gang.
Yeah.
So congrats on that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I want you to speak on what I just asked you, and then we got to speak on D-Wade shit. I want your output on that, because because I, as a father, you got a son.
Yeah.
I need to hear. Need to hear what's your like what's your thoughts on that? Go ahead.
Yeah, I got two sons, you know.
Yeah.
I got three.
Yeah. So I guess first so I guess I answer this. We gotta get the D-Wade shit first, because you just hit that, you know, that out there.
It's fresh on your mind.
Yeah. So, I mean, to be honest, I don't have, I would say, a problem with either of my children, you know, the male gender, saying that they were gay. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I would love them the same. I would just have to coach them, you know, that way instead of the other way. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, make sure you be safe. Parental things. But to allow your son to, like, just change their gender at the age of 12, I feel like that's a lifelong commitment that no 12-year-old should be able to make. You know what I'm saying? Like, because, again, like I said, I would be open and accepting. Yeah, it's cool. You know, be gay, whatever. But I wouldn't recommend you do that. Hey, let's go a couple more years, see how you feel later on down the line. You know what I'm saying? Don't.
Would you try to do, like, little booby traps to set them up to try to go the opposite way?
You know, me being the nigga that I am, yes.
Okay.
Real shit.
You know, but at the end of the day, I'm not going to, you know, just blatantly, you know, be against it. Absolutely. You know what I'm saying? Like, because I'm not against it. I love everybody. I support everybody. But at the end of the day, I don't want it to be a situation where it's like, maybe, you know, this person was just robbed of an experience. Like, because some people that are gay that I know, they've just never even been with a girl, period. So that it's like, how can you not know? You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, that's crazy, right? So it's like,
no, never been with a hell of a time.
That's
out.
Why.
So no. So is it like that? Is they're gay because they just never ever got the shot of
I don't
getting
know.
Pussy?
And that's what I'm saying. That's probably why I would booby trap my kids like that. You know what I'm saying? Because you know you could be the changing factor. You know what I'm saying? So
there gotta be a job, you know. You know, we gotta create that for the fathers. Yeah. We gotta create.
Well, you know, they have this thing where you know, you got dad groups, or you have just friends. Your friends have kids.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you kind of try and do it like on some royalty shit, like right. You know, oh, kings and queens. You know, they didn't have their kids just fucking anybody.
Mm.
They was inbreeding. They were fucking each other, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, nowadays I think it's more reasonable and cultural for us. You know, we have friends that we kind of partner our kids with. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Age, you know what I'm saying? You know, kick it like, oh, you know, male, female, y'all best friends, but at the end of the day, y'all grow up, y'all probably gonna be something, you know what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah.
So that's another way to kind of do that too, you know, but
that sounds like the way.
Yeah.
To be real.
For the people who have lost their way, that's the way. Yeah.
You know, that's the way. No, it's way more lost ways now. Let's be real.
Right.
Like it's the nigga. The world is gay now, nigga. There's parades.
I mean, look,
there's
though.
Fucking parades.
So, look, I'm a really big conspiracy theorist guy, you know, and I really honestly feel that, you know, again, the system is working effectively. I feel like the agenda, you know, of the powers to be is for there to be less people in the world because, you know, global warming, you know, everything's changing. They think the world's going to end. So they're trying to save as much space as they can for the people with money. So instead of like just continuously killing people off and like mass, you know, what they say, acts of God, you know, because I feel like that could be manipulated. What they're also doing is trying to turn everyone gay so that there's no more, you know, breeding. You know, you're not making any more children. You know what I'm saying? So, because, you know, when you're on the same sex, y'all can't have kids.
Right.
So, it makes sense in my mind. But, again, I said, you know, like, I'm just a big conspiracy theorist. It could not be true. But it makes sense.
It makes sense.
I'm going to be real. Some shit is just not to be understood. And I'm going to take that as that.
But think about this, though, too, in that same regard. We know who controls everything, right? TV, radio, communications,
absolutely.
Right? When you were little, did you remember seeing any gay people on TV?
Hell yeah.
Cartoons and
cartoons? Mean, not. I'm talking about. No, I don't know, man. It always been gay people on TV. Though.
I mean, but look, not the way they portray it now, though.
Yeah. Now it's extreme. Now,
it's at least two gay characters on every show, cartoon or not.
Facts.
For kids or not.
Niggas won't kissing on TV. Bitches won't kissing on TV.
That
now
shit was
like
porn,
regular.
But now that's regular TV.
That's regular.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's regular now.
So that's where my mind is with it, with the conspiracy theorists, because it's like, why would you be openly forcing people to be gay, it seems like? You know?
It is, right.
You know, why would you be doing that if that wasn't your agenda? So that's just my mind with it, you know. But again, I love all people, dog.
Me you know too. I do, but I just want to know what is up with all that shit. Because it's like the way that it is a big difference from us like 10 years ago to now.
It is.
Like,
it
it's
is.
A big difference.
I remember being in school and niggas got beat up because they were gay.
Right.
But now being gay is cool. And like I said, I don't have anything against it. But times have changed. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? It's everywhere now.
Right.
You know, like they almost want you to be gay.
Absolutely.
So
that shit. Well, look, man. To all the gay fans, shout out to you.
Shout out
to all community. Our straight fans. Shout out to you.
Shout out
to all our fans. Shout out to you.
Shout out.
That's all that matters now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I don't care what you is.
Mm.
Just be a fan.
Mm.
And motherfucking cop some motherfucking champagne.
Sweet. Yeah.
And nigga, we gonna talk about her.
Sweet.
So basically what we are gonna do now, man, cause niggas, like I said, niggas is getting streams now.
Mm.
This is new for me.
Mm.
I'm taking all this in right now with
talk
you at the same
shit,
time.
Boy.
You yeah, feel me? Yeah. So we gonna play this record, and I'm gonna let it rock a little bit because
yeah. Yeah.
Thanking God 'cause I'm free. Yeah. Thanking God 'cause of me. Kick the nigga dope, put him on the floor, get the bands, then we flee. Cop a lot of chains and a lot of rings. Smile.